can't stop it. Block it when I drop it. Anytime I go rhyme for rhyme on a topic. They ain't even fit to step in Shaq's arena. I look inside your mind and I see your sugar demeanor. In your eyes, why are you surprised? No matter how you try, not fly as Eloquaz. The new addition, is this the end of your last night? In the daytime, you couldn't see me with a flashlight. I crash lights on sights of my enemy. I'm coming through and then I bomb your whole vicinity.
Attack skills and vocabulary too. I'm a hit in the district, this is all brand new. Get through, I'm interplanetarian like Doctor Who. So who?
Fuck your beef, no relief. I step on stage, girls scream like I'm Keith.
What's up, everybody? KLS Sports is back at it again. Haven't done a show in a long time. Haven't done a sports show. We haven't done the Ring Time Pro Wrestling in a long time. But I got a new mic. I want to test it out. Hey man, y'all about to get this work. It's going to be a short show. Day after my birthday. Happy birthday to me. Your boy is celebrating his Hank Aaron year, 44. Headed to Michigan to see some family. And we're going to have a good time. We're going to produce a good show for you today. We're not going to delve into too many deep topics. I'll probably save that for next week. I really plan on doing this again next week. So we'll talk about the state of college football, NFL, all the interesting storylines, and because it's KLS kind of like sports, we will deal with how those interact with society and what's going on the world around us. So without further ado, let's get to what we came here for today. It is a football preview. So, for those who have followed this website, I have done a weekly preview of the major football teams here in the state of Georgia. I figured I'd do that and I'd bring it to the podcast. So I'll go through the teams. Our two Sun Belt Conference teams, Georgia Southern, Georgia State, which me and Keisha are both alums of, respectively. Then you have University of Georgia and Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech is a special university in our family. Our mom, who is no longer with us, worked there for over 20 years, so we have a pretty good bond with Georgia Tech. So let's start with Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech has been a solid team this year. They had a real tough loss at Louisville. And they had a loss at Ole Miss, which I think they could have won, actually. Well, let's not say they could have won. I felt like they could have stayed in that game offensively. But, you know, they made just the right amount of mistakes at the wrong time and ended up losing. But this week, they are facing Bowling Green in a non-ACC contest. And I think that they'll be very fine against Bowling Green. It'll be 3:30 on the ACC network. I think Brent Key has really got this team humming. I think they're overwhelming favorites here against Bowling Green. Their quarterback, Hayes King, has proved to be a really good quarterback for them, replacing the talented Jeff Sims, who really hasn't gotten off the schneid down there where he's at. But yeah, Bowling Green is 1-3. Tech is 2-2. Tech will leave this game 3-2, and I expect them to keep on rolling. The current schedule as it rolls out now, after Bowling Green, they'll face Miami, number 18 Miami, which should be a pretty good game at Miami. Boston College should be pretty solid, and North Carolina. Every game left on the schedule is winnable until you get down to Georgia. Syracuse, Clemson, they'll all be tough games, but they're all winnable. I mean, I think Georgia Tech could be back in a bowl game this season for the first time in a long time. So, that's Georgia Tech. I'll save Georgia for last. So, let's do Georgia Southern versus Coastal Carolina, which is interesting. The game is kind of a push. I think we're giving Coastal Carolina a little bit. No, actually, Georgia Southern is favored. Southern has looked decent this year. Not the best, but decent enough. The game is going to be played on the NFL Network, which is interesting. But, yeah, we played at 7 p.m., Georgia Southern 3-1, and Their only loss was to a Power 5 in Wisconsin when they got blown out. But they beat Ball State, a MAC team. UAB, which is always a good team. Citadel, which is can be here or there. Coastal Carolina, who's fresh off a loss to Georgia State. And their only real wins. They played UCLA pretty decent. But their other wins were Duquesne and Jacksonville State. So, yeah, I expect a lot for a Georgia Southern offense that's putting up 480 yards a game, 340 in the air, which, if you follow the Eagles over the years, that is not how they usually get down. That number is usually flipped, and they're rushing for 139 yards a game. So, let's see what they have going, and let's see if they can keep it up. Next up is the undefeated Georgia State Panthers, 4-0. And might be the favorites to at least take the East Division of the Sun Belt Conference. Right now, riding this four-game streak where they've beaten Coastal Carolina, UNC Charlotte, UConn, and Rhode Island. This week, they face Troy. And there's no reason to believe that they should not beat Troy. They are heavy favorites. ESPN has them as 66% favorites. So, let's see if Georgia State can keep this thing rolling. 5-0 would be a hell of a start for the Panthers. Probably one of the best starts in school history. So let's see what they got going. And last but not least, the University of Georgia, the number one team in the nation, the Bulldogs, will be taking on the Auburn Tigers. I don't really have to go to a lot of previews. This is what I would say. Georgia has to not play down to their competition. I think that's what happened against South Carolina. I think they played down to the competition for a half, and then they showed up and was Georgia. It happened last year against Missouri. Like, I think they played down to the competition, and then, they eventually, but you can't shake that every time. And as good as this team is this year, you have a lot of losses to the NFL, even though they've brought in a lot of good talent. Eventually, it's going to catch up to you, right? So, they can't play down to Auburn, who has been struggling, who really, I don't think they have a direction of that program right now. Auburn's currently 3-1, but it's like a solid 3-1. Their wins, a 14-10 win against Cal, a blowout against UMass, Samford. First time they played a real team was Texas A&M last week, and they lost 27-10. And, Texas A&M ain't exactly riding high right now, right? So, I don't expect much for Auburn. But I don't want Georgia looking forward either. And that's another problem. They're going to be down at Jordan-Hare Stadium, so that's one thing. But you really don't want Georgia to be looking too far ahead. Kentucky is next week. Then they got Vanderbilt, which is kind of, eh. The schedule really doesn't pick up for them until, the Florida week. Then it's Florida, Missouri, Ole Miss, and Tennessee. They really got, Georgia got maybe the worst SEC schedule I've seen in a long time. There's no heavy hitters. There's no LSU. There's no Bama. There's no, they not swinging at anybody. So this is going to be interesting. And then they'll ride it out to the SEC title game. But then again, I'm going to say this, and this is going to sound crazy, but is this a down SEC year? Because Alabama doesn't look like juggernauts, right? They're 3-1. They got beat by Texas. They've been struggling to sputter. They sputtered against South Florida. Are we looking at a down SEC year? LSU, we really don't know much to make of them. They got busted by Florida State, but Florida State's been really good, so I don't know. Ole Miss, I've watched almost every Ole Miss game this year. I've written for it for Self Bound and Down, and I'm going to tell you that, they haven't really lit it on fire. I don't know, man. This could be what we consider a down year for the SEC. But, just saying it now. Georgia's ranked number one, but after that, you really don't have a lot of upper-tier SEC teams. LSU is ranked 10 or what is LSU ranked? 13. Alabama's at 12. But Florida's at 22. Ole Miss at 20. Missouri's at 23. We barely got guys hanging into the top 25. like, I don't know, where generally, like, there's usually like three teams in the top 10 at this early junction of the season where we're only four games deep. So, I mean, I think we should wait and see. Like, it's going to be interesting. But this show's like 10 minutes. I'm not going to drag it out. Really, this was just to test this new microphone my wonderful family bought me. And I am really happy that we are here to do this show. But I do plan on doing more shows. I do plan on doing more Ring Time Pro Wrestling. Me and Keisha always talk about it. And we're going to be here and continue. And I just... happy y'all continue to listen. But we're out. Peace. Also, pay attention to my writing. I am still a SEC contributor over at South Down and Down on Fansided. I'm looking for a new writing home for my NBA work. And I will start producing content for the websites again. So just be on the lookout. Peace.